using the power series method to solve the differential equation x squared plus 1 y double prime plus 2 x y prime is equal to 0 and y of 0 is equal to 0 y prime of 0 equals 0 equals 1. So first let's find p of x and q of x. So p of x is equal to 2x over x squared plus 1, don't forget to divide by the least coefficient, and q of x is equal to 0. So you can see that x equals 0 is an ordinary point. So our solution is given in this form, y equals power series from 0 to infinity, cn times x to the n. Take the first derivative, gives me power series from 1 to infinity, cn times n times x to the n minus 1. So you bring down the exponent, then subtract the exponent by 1. Take the second derivative, gives me power series from 2 to infinity, cn n n minus 1, x to the n minus 2. Again, bring down the exponent, subtract the exponent by 1. So for this one, y in starts at 1 instead of 0, because if you plug in 0, it will make this become 0. And same reason for this one, if you plug in either 0 or 1, it will make this become 0. Okay, so always check if n equals a number is working or not. Alright, now what I'm going to do next is to plug this into the differential equation. But before I do that, I'm going to distribute this out first, because we'll make my math easier, okay? So I have y x squared y double prime plus y double prime plus 2xy prime is equal to 0, right? Now we plug y prime and y double prime into this one, okay? So I have power series from 2 to infinity, yeah, you guys can see it, cnn minus 1 x to the n, okay? Just x to the n, why? Because you have x squared times x to the n minus 1, so same base, add the exponent together. Okay, now plus power series from 2 to infinity, cnn n minus 1, x to the n minus 2, plus power series from 1 to infinity, 2 cnn x to the n, just x to the n, why? Because x times x to the n minus 1, so same base, add the exponent together, okay, it's equal to 0. Alright, now what I'm going to do next is to take a look at the x to the power. So plug in 2, x to the second, plug in 2, x to the 0, plug in 1, x to the first. So x to the second is the highest exponent. That means that I have to run out of terms for these two power series. So let's rewrite the first one. Right? Now for this one, when n equals 2, plug in 2, I have 2 minus 1 is 1, 1 times 2 is 2, 2 c 2, plus n equals 3, plug in 3, so 3 minus 1 is 2, 2 times 3 is 6, plus 6c3x plus power series from 4 to infinity, cnn minus 1 x to the n minus 2, plus, so n equals 1, plug in 1, so I have 2 times 1 is 2, 2c1x plus the power series from 2 to infinity, 2cnn x to the n is equal to 0, right? Now let's take a look at the index. So we have n equals 2, n equals 4, n equals 2, so we reindex n equals 4 to n equals 2. You could reindex the 2, but I don't think you would do that, because it takes more time to reindex 2 instead of reindexing 1, okay? So let's reindex this. So reindex it to 2. So lower 2, that means that I have to increase 2 for every single n inside. So I have cn plus 2, n plus 2, n plus 1, x to the n, right? So here's how you check if you've done it correctly or not. So if you've done this correctly, you're going to have all the power series start at the same n, which is 2 in this case, and they are multiplied by x to the n, right? Now we are going to combine like terms. So we have 2c2 plus, so just 2c2 for the x to the 0. Now for the x terms, so we have 6c3x plus 2c1x, trying to factor out x. So 6c3 plus 2c1 times x, plus the power series from 2 to infinity, right? Because they do have x to the n in common, so we factor out x to the n and put it at the end. So let's see, we have cn times n minus 1, cn plus 1, cn. So cn plus 2 is the highest c, so we write the highest c first. Now for this one, if you take a look at these, so we have cn and we have cn over here. So factor out cnn. So I have n minus 1 plus 2. Okay. Now we are going to equate coefficient. So I have 2c2 is equal to 0. So c2 is 0. 6c3 plus 2c1 is equal to 0. Solve for the biggest c, which is c3. So I have c3 equal negative c1 over 3. So negative 2c1 divided by 6, which is negative 1/3 c1. Now, for this one, everything inside the bracket. So let everything inside the bracket equal 0. So I have n cn plus 2, n plus 2, n plus 1, plus cn n n min So have n minus 1 plus 0. So simplify this will give me n plus 1 is equal to 0. Then solve for the biggest C. So we have cn plus 2 and cn. So cn plus 2 is the biggest C. So solve for cn plus 2. Then I have negative cn n plus 1 all over n plus 2. N plus 1, right? Oh, look at this. So we have n plus 1. N plus 1, please drop out. And n is starting from 2 to infinity, okay? Now when n equals 2, so I have c4. Plug in 2, so I have c4 equals negative 2 c2 over 4. To simplify this, then I have 1 half c2. And what is c2? C2 is 0. So it's just 0. When n equals 3, so I have c5. C5 is equal to plug in 3, so 3, negative 3 c3 over 5. What is c3? C3 is negative 1 over 3, so negative 1 times negative 3, which is 3. 3 divided by 3 is 1, so I have c1 over 5. N equals 4, I have c6 is equal to negative 4 c4 over 6. So what is c4? C4 is 0, so this is just 0. When n equals 5, I have c7. What is c7? C7 is negative 5c5 over 7. So c5, c5, c1 over 5. So, negative 5 times c1 over 5, which is c1 over 7, okay? Now let me do one more if you don't see the pattern here. So c8, c8 is equal to negative 6c6 over 8, which is 0 because c6 is 0. So the rest of the power series will be in terms of 0 and c1, okay? Then I'm going to write out solution here. Right? So y equals c0 plus c1x plus c2x squared plus c3x cubed plus dot dot dot. What is c0? We don't know, just rewrite it. What is c1? We don't know, just rewrite it. What is c2? C2 is 0. What is c3? C3 is negative c1 over 3x cubed. What is c4? C4 is 0. What is c5? C5 is c1 over 5x to the 5th. C6? 0. C7? Negative c1 over 7x to the 7 plus 0 plus dot dot dot, okay? Now, let's factor out c0. So I have c0. Oops. So I have only one c0 here. Plus, so c1, so the rest of power series will be in terms of c1. So factor out c1, I have x minus 1 third x cubed plus 1 fifth x to the fifth minus 1 seventh x to the seventh plus dot dot dot, okay? Typically, this is your final solution, okay? But because we are given initial value problem, so we have to solve for c0 and c1. Okay, so we know that y of 0 equals 0 and y prime of 0 equals 1. So I'm going to plug in 0 for y first. So y of 0 is equal to plug in 0 for x. So I have 0 minus 0 plus 0. So the rest of power series is going to be 0. And this equals 0. That means that c1, c0, it's equal 0, okay? Then we write this. I have c1 x minus 1 third x cubed plus 1 fifth x to the fifth minus 1 7 x to the 7 plus dot dot dot. Now take the derivative of this one. So I have derivative of x is 1 minus x squared plus x to the fourth minus x to the sixth plus dot dot dot. Okay, so bring that exponent and subtract the exponent by 1. So 3 divided by 3 is 1. 3 minus 1 is 0. So x squared, same for these, all the way down to infinity. Now y prime of 0. So plug in 0 for x. So I have 1 minus 0 plus 0, so the rest of this series is just 0, and this equals 1. So that means that we have c1 equals 1, okay? Now let's go back to this general solution, and because c0 is 0, so this becomes 0, and then c1 is 1, so our final solution will be like this. So this is your final solution, okay? That's it. If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.